catch.
Metal forks are better, they're more sturdy. Plastic forks are junk, they break.
I don't know is not an answer acceptable to me.
explain yourself. Do you want to use this plastic fork forever?
No.
You want to use this stupid plastic fork forever? But do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
Never throw the fork again. Never throw it away.
Okay.
Otherwise, we'll have problems. And these will be back on your wrist.
You must save the forks. Don't be Miriam.
Ready to go dump our stuff?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So lunch today, how was that?
It was okay.
It's hard to eat with a plastic fork.
Aren't those Nyx glasses?
Don't throw away forks.
What is Entra?
Do you get a partner?
It's something that starts when students are juniors. They go through an application process. They fill out an application, go through an interview process. They're accepted or rejected according to their application and their interview. And when they're seniors, they actually have the class for 4 of the 6 terms. And within the class, each student or groups of students, they have a choice of having a partner or not. They set up a business and run it to the best of their ability. They can sell things in the store, in the school. Or outside the school as well. So that's a big part of it. Also within the class, seniors are required to take a consumer economics class, consumer econ, and then within the class they fulfill those requirements as well. We set aside enough time to take care of those things as well.
Who teaches Entra?
That would be me, Mr. Hinkmeyer. I'm the instructor for the entrepreneurship class.
Do you have to come to class prepared with ideas?
You do not have to have an idea. In fact, some of them maybe still are looking for some ideas.
Is there limitations on what you can make?
Students are not really limited. Their ideas do have to be approved by myself and Mr. Jensen here at the high school.
Do you make a profit off of what you sell?
Hopefully, yes. The students, they do get to keep the money that they profit, or they have to suffer the loss of any money that they lost. But there are a couple of things during the course of the school year that they are asked to make donations to.
Do you have to spend money to make money?
Not necessarily always.
Do you have to contact the manufacturer by yourself?
I give them the chance to do it on their own. In fact, I ask them, encourage them to venture out and make contacts on their own, because it's a good life lesson for them. I do make myself available and direct them to certain people once in a while, but for the most part, they do that on their own. I've been teaching the Entre class for 7 years. I've only been teaching for 7 years. So when I first came here, I started teaching it right away. It was in my regular course of classes. We had a school store, a smaller version, and then we lost that with all the remodeling. It took a while to get to this point, but it looks like we're on the right track. So to say that we came up with the idea isn't necessarily true. It was something that was here prior to the remodeling that took place. Well, I would say somewhere between 2 and 3 years, because we did have something last year, but it never really took off. I guess the failure of last year's store, or the lack of success, might be better than saying failure, but that was part of it. And then the administrators kind of took it upon themselves to kind of secure this place, where the store is at right now, and the new windows that were put in and that sort of thing. So that was kind of the process. Mr. Jensen and other administrators realizing that we needed something better than what we had.